wonderful world of Disney.
When the sun came up this morning, I took the time to watch it rise. And as its beauty struck the darkness from the sky, I thought how small and unimportant all my troubles seemed to be, and how lucky another day belongs to me. And as the sleepy world around me woke up to greet the day, all its silent beauty seemed to say, so what, my friend, if all your dreams you haven't realized, just look around you. You've got a whole new day to try. Today is mine, today is mine, to do with what I will. Today is mine, my own special cup to fill, to die. I might learn to live, to take from life, that I might learn to give. Today is mine. Today is mine. Today is mine. To do with. Today is mine, my own special cup to fill, to die a little, that I might learn to live, to take from life, that I might learn to give. Today is mine.
I'm Julie Andrews, and I'm here at the opening of the Walt Disney World in Florida, just a few miles away from Cape Kennedy, where men point their space vehicles toward the stars. Walt Disney decided to launch his final dream. A commitment to the future for your children and mine. This is a world of lakes and waterways, of incredible new rides and illusions, of wildlife sanctuaries for nature's creatures, as well as camping grounds and golf courses and all manner of wonderful things for the human species. Best of all, it is a place to stir the imagination and instill a sense of hope for tomorrow. A joyful land built by an inspired dreamer for other dreamers and dreams still to come. The time, now. Occasion, the opening of Walt Disney World. The place, Orlando, Florida.
The grand opening of Walt Disney World, starring Julie Andrews. Special guest star, Glen Campbell. Also starring Buddy Hackett, Jonathan Winters. In special tribute to Walt Disney, Bob Hope,
Zippity-doo-dah-day, zippity-doo-dah-day, zippity-doo-dah-day. Well, Margaret, here we are at Disney World Campgrounds. Yay! All right, you little beggars. Here, you get out, all right? Head over there to the campsite. Hurry up now. Come on, Mavis, Teddy, Sissy. June, you get over there. Harry, Tony, run over in that area. Just move around at will. That's all right. Pick up some sticks and some firewood. Well, Margaret, we made it to the campgrounds. That wasn't too bad a drive, was it? After all, it was only 2 days and two nights from Fort Smith. I didn't bug you too much, did it? Margaret, well, what about me sitting on this side all the time going bumpity-bumpity, bumpity-bumpity-bump? Wasn't easy for me. I guess you must have hit 1,000 chuckles between Fort Smith and here. Oh, come on, Margaret. Huh? Listen, let me tell you something. We didn't do this vacation for me or the kids. We did this for you, Margaret, so you could get out of that hot, sweaty kitchen and have the fun of your life right here in Disney World. Huh? I'm going to get out now, Margaret, and come around and get you. What is it with you? Why, you seem to be out on your feet. I can't believe this. You're not going to tell me that you're tired, that you can't hack it. Come on, Margaret. Get out of there. Let's get out and carry some water and maybe... Here, wait a minute. Let me help you. Are your hands frozen to the wheel? Here. Why, they're like claws. That'll be great for carrying water, Margaret. Here, let's get the other one. All right, come on your feet. We're going to have some fun. Chop some firewood. Maybe find some wildlife over here, take some pictures. The kids are... What are you doing, Margaret? What is this kind of a walk? Huh? Well, you're some kind of female Frankenstein. You're going to scare the kids if you do this. Put your hands down. Stop that. Well, you look like Smokey the Bear after you've been struck by lightning. Get over here. Sit down here, Margaret. Why, I just can't... Margaret, I can't believe this. Here, you kids. Mavis, Billy Joe, come over here. Mavis and Billy, Jean, come over here. Never mind, Billy, you stay back there. Get a hold of the tent over here, you kids. You grab her here by the wrists. Start moving them like that. Here, honey, down around the ankles. You're dogging it, Margaret. You're dogging it. Huh? What are you trying to tell me, Margaret? You see, you talked too much in the earlier years when we were first married. Now you've lost your voice. Huh? Oh, too bad. All right, you kids, run off now. Go off there and... Off in there into the wilds. There's a lot of things to see. Come on, Margaret. We're going to have some fun, sweetheart. On your feet now. Come on, this is your holiday.
Hi, I'm Glen Campbell, and I'm on the lake side of the new Contemporary Hotel. You'll see it in a minute. Now, what I'm trying to do here is kind of clear my head after seeing some of the things that you'll glimpse on the show today. Now, we all know magic is the Disney people's special business, so I was halfway ready for them to wave a magic wand and see swamps drain away and to watch lakes and lagoons appear and rivers begin to flow. I expected to see miracles take place in all sizes, small, medium, large, and family size, of course. But when I found out that Walt Disney World is twice as big as the island of Manhattan, I just had to stop and think about that a minute. Now, here's something you don't see as you enter your average hotel. Which brings us to something else. Now, they say the old Spanish explorers used to look for the Fountain of Youth around these parts. Now, I'd say they were a little bit too early. If you're looking for the spirit of eternal youth, here he is right now. My golfing buddy, Mr. Bob Hope.
Thank you. Thank you. How do you do? How do you you, ladies and gentlemen. This is Bob X-Mouseketeer Hope.
Boy, they don't build mice the way they used to, do they?
Thank you, girls. Wait for me in Adventureland. How about this? Isn't this a beautiful place? And how about that mural? Look at that mural. When John Wayne doodles, he doodled. Hey, what a building. Now I know where the Goodyear blimp goes during the mating season. Now, this place is so big, by the time you cross the lobby, your luggage stickers have faded. You saw this beautifully engineered modern hotel from the outside. It has a very unusual shape. Matter of fact, a nearsighted flamingo has been sitting on the tower for weeks trying to hatch it. It's really two buildings leaning against each other. And I want to congratulate the architect, Dean Martin. Now, the rooms are fabulous. They even have weather control, which is wonderful for guests from Los Angeles. They can have smog anytime they want it. It's really different. A lot of hotels put a Bible in your room, but here, Billy Graham comes up and reads it to you. I have a lovely room with complete privacy, except in the bathtub, which Donald Duck shares with me. Did you ever try bathing with a duck who was playing with his rubber man? And I ordered lunch from room service. Snow White brought it in, and I was afraid to eat the apple. I don't dare drink the water because that was delivered by Pluto. I'm sorry, I can't wait. My monorail will be here any minute. But this is the biggest vacation complex entertainment in the world. And to think it all started with a gentle mouse, a bad-tempered duck, and seven mixed-up dwarfs. I must say, it's a fantastic achievement. They took a swamp and turned it into a magic kingdom. It wasn't easy. Have you ever tried to relocate 8,000 angry alligators? And there's so much to see here. I love Fantasyland. Fantasyland, you know, that's like Agnew winning the National Open. Then I went to Tomorrowland, which shows how it'll be 100 years from now. There's a whole section devoted to the Paris peace talks. About the only way I can describe Disney World is to give it the highest compliment that you can give to anything man-made. Ralph Nader would like it. And now I'd like you to stick around for a while and see what's been done and what's going to be done. You know, Walt Disney always believed in the beauty and natural wonders of the world. But he felt as we pass through, we should try to add a little wonder and beauty to it. Maybe you'll understand that Walt's dream was just a beginning. The dream doesn't stop here. This is the start of it. I think you might want to tell your grandchildren you were there when it happened.
If I seem a bit eager, it's because a warm and wonderful event is about to take place. From every part of the world, some 140 musicians, representing the major symphony orchestras of their respective cities, have journeyed here to join in a special tribute to Walt Disney and the opening of Walt Disney World. Under the baton of Arthur Fiedler, they have already performed before members of the United Nations at the Philharmonic Hall in New York City. And tomorrow evening, they give a final performance at the John F. Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts in Washington, D.C. But at this moment, these outstanding musicians have assembled here to join their hearts and musicianship in one glowing message for all.
doubt about it, music is an international language. The only thing is, when you get down around my part of the country, it has a little bit of an accent, you know. Now, we're about to hear the Disney Audio Animatronics Bear Band stomp out some of my kind of music, like this. Eat your heart out, Jerry Reed.
The Bear Band bands will play now in the good old key of G. Zeke and Zeb and Ted and Fred and Bear named Tennessee. Zeke's twanging on banjo and a tapping with his feet. A banging on a dish pan with a real old country beat. Zeb the sawing on the fiddle with a crooked hickory bow. When the spirit moves that ruin, he can make that fiddle go. Brother Ted is on the corn jug. Now I mean that bear can blow. He also plays the washboard with the handle of a hoe. And Big Fred's playing mouth harp. He plays it kind of sad. He never took a lesson. He just picked it up from Dad. And Lil' Old Tennessee Bear is a featured on the thing. Sounds just like a guitar, but it's only got one string. Clap your hands and stomp your feet and try to keep right with them. One sure thing the Bear Band's got is real old country rhythm. Yeah, clap your hands and stomp your feet and try to keep right with them. One sure thing the Bear Band's got is real old country rhythm. And now, a heart rendering ditty by our own growler of soul, Liverlips McGraw. Sing it, Mac.
I got a woman, she's got me. Whatever we do, we both agree. She ain't pretty, but I ain't too. The things we like are the things we do. A woman ain't pretty, but she don't swear none. She's kinda heavy, don't weigh a ton. She's my woman through and through. I love her only cause the heart is true.
Now here they come, those little sunbonnets from the Sunshine State, Bunny, Bubbles, and Beulah.
Every time I meet a guy who gets me shook, all I ever get from him's a dirty look. It's the same way everywhere I found. All the guys that turn me on, turn me down. All the guys that turn me on, turn me down. Nothing works for me that I've found. It's the same way everywhere I see. Nothing ever seems to work for me. Nothing ever seems to work for me.
There was blood on the sand and blood all around and a great big puddle of blood on the ground.
Born on the mountaintop in Tennessee, greenest state in the land of the free. Raised in the woods so he knew every tree. Tamed him a bar when he was only three. Davy Crockett, king of the wild frontier. Out through the woods he's a marching along,
making up yarns and singing a song.
It's perfect.
Hey, wait a minute. Hold the phone down there. You've had your turn
Henry.
Now.
Henry, we need
blood
help.
All right, Sammy. Hey, gang, hit it.
He's big around the middle and he's broad across the rump. 9 miles an hour, taking 30 feet of jumps. Hang on the big bird, hang on the big tree. Some folks say it's a lot like me.
Blood on the sand.
High on a mountain, tell me what do you see? Bear tracks, looking back at me. Better get your rifle, cause the war is too late. The bear's calling him big and heading through the gate. He's big around the middle and he's broad across the room. 90 miles an hour, taking 30 feet a jump. Ain't never been cornered, ain't never been tweed. Some folks say he looks a lot like me.
This morning, something inside of me told me this would be my day. I heard the morning train, I felt the wind change. Too many times I'm on my way. Come on, sunshine, what can you show me? Where can you take me to make me understand? The wind can shake me, brothers forsake me. The rain can touch me, but can I touch the rain? Then I saw the sunrise above a cotton sky, like a candy cane delight. I saw the milkman, I saw the businessman, I saw the only road in sight. And then I got to thinking, what makes you want to go to know the wherefore and the why? So many times now, oh Lord, I can't remember if it's September or July. Come on, sunshine, what can you show me? Where can you take me to make me understand? The wind can shake me, brothers forsake me. The rain can touch me, but can I touch the rain? It came to me, I saw the wherefore, and you can see it if you try. It's in the sun above, it's in the ones you love. You'll never know the reason why. Come on, sunshine, what can you show me? Where can you take me to make me understand? The wind can shake me, brothers forsake me. The rain can touch me, but can I touch the rain? So much to lose, so much to gain.
You know, every now and then, I think we get the idea that freedom is our right, so we can shape it to our own personal convenience. But I don't think it's meant to be that way at all. You see, freedom isn't a divisible thing that you can cut up and keep the lion's share for yourself, with others getting what's left over. This here is Liberty Square. It's the heart of Disney World. And I'll tell you, it's a great place just to think and feel. There are other things here to remind us, too, that freedom didn't come to us on a silver platter. All around us here are the streets of colonial America. Shops, meeting houses, taverns, farms, and the forges. It's where our liberties were born. This here is the Hall of Presidents. So come on in and meet the special and remarkable group of men who brought us along the journey of our nation's life from the very beginning. It's a great place.
Thank you. In this Hall of Presidents, let us pay homage to the immortal men whose illustrious names have been indelibly inscribed on history's roll of honor. George Washington, John Adams, Thomas Jefferson, James Madison, James Monroe, John Quincy Adams, Andrew Jackson, Martin Van Buren, William Henry Harrison, John Tyler, James K. Polk, Zachary Taylor, Millard Fillmore, Franklin Pierce, James Buchanan, Abraham Lincoln, Andrew Johnson, Ulysses S. Grant, Rutherford B. Hayes, James A. Garfield, Chester A. Arthur, Grover Cleveland, Benjamin Harrison, William McKinley, Theodore Roosevelt, William Howard Taft, Woodrow Wilson, Warren G. Harding, Calvin Coolidge, Herbert Hoover, Franklin D. Roosevelt, Harry S. Truman, Dwight D. Eisenhower, John F. Kennedy, Lyndon B. Johnson, Richard M. Nixon.
This government must be preserved in spite of the acts of any man or set of men. Nowhere in the world is presented a government of so much liberty and equality. To the humblest and poorest among us are held the highest privileges and positions. What constitutes the bulwark of our liberty and independence? It is not the frowning battlements or bristling sea coast, our army and navy. These are not our reliance against tyranny. Our reliance is in the love of liberty, which God has planted in us. Our defense is in the spirit which prizes liberty as the heritage of all men, in all lands everywhere. Destroy this spirit, and you have planted the seeds of despotism at your own doors. At what point shall we expect the approach of danger? By what means shall we fortify against it? Shall we expect some transatlantic giant to step the ocean and crush us at a blow? Never. All the armies of Europe, Asia, and Africa combined could not by force take a drink from the Ohio or make a track on the Blue Ridge. At what point, then, is the approach of danger to be expected? I answer, if it ever reach us, it must spring up among us. It cannot come from abroad. If destruction be our lot, we ourselves must be its author and its finisher. As a nation of free men, we must live through all time or die by suicide. Surely God would not have created such a being as man with ability to grasp the infinite, to exist only for a day. No. No. Man was made for immortality.
Thank you. Margaret, you've done a fantastic job here. This canvas is perfect. It's very taut. I see the legs here are in tight in the ground, and then all the pegs. Why, that's just great, Margaret. I'm very proud of you, and I love this campsite. It's just fantastic. Margaret, come on, get a hold of yourself. Here, let's get up. You've got to straighten up here a little bit. Why, you're all bent over, Margaret. Here, straighten up. Isn't it strange, you know, after all these years that we've been married, you get much taller than I do. You get taller and taller, and I get shorter and shorter. You don't suppose you've been fooling around with those voodoo dolls again, have you? Huh? Tell me the truth now, Margaret. Here, let's move right over here. You sit right here, and we'll gather the kids around, right here by the fire. That's good, Margaret. Right down there. Take your time, my dear. Here we go. All right, kids, everybody, come on. Let's gather around here. It's time once again for our family powwow. Daddy gets his feather here. All right, you get situated around Mommy there. Yes, sir, and I'll put my feather in. There we go. Gang. All right. Say, Willie, what do you got there? Let me take a look at those. Uh-oh, those aren't robin's eggs. No, sir, those are Mommy alligator eggs. That's what they are. You better be careful and you put those back right away, or Mommy alligator will get after you and go, and you'd be gone just like that. Ah, that gnat. What was that gnat? What's the matter, Mavis? Did you think that was Tinkerbell? Why, I'd know Tinkerbell if I saw her. That little funny gnat. It is Tinkerbell. Gee, I almost crippled her. Take a look at her wings. One of them's bent. Here, I'll straighten that out. You see that? What I'll do is just work those wings back and forth. Maybe give her a little mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. Ever do that to a gnat? It's not easy. There she goes. Isn't that fantastic? Good luck to you, Tinkerbell. Mother, that gives me an idea. Margaret, pull yourself together. The kids are staring at you. Listen, how about a little game? Remember that fantastic game where I play William Tell and you stand there maybe about 50 or 75 yards away with an apple on your head? Huh? Remember that, Margaret? Remember that, kids? And I forgot to put the rubber tip on last time. And Mom, right in the head. She had some kind of headache, didn't she? Where is Mommy? Hey, kids, come on. Let's go get Mommy. Here. Remember? All right, everybody in unison. We're gonna track down Mommy, everybody. We're gonna track down Mommy. Yes.
In the islands, there seem to be many occasions for joy. One of them is the luau. On the beach in front of the Polynesian village in Disney World, there's one taking place right now.
Hold back your boredom
and hide the ennui.
think it's over.
Well, it's just begun.
There's no need to holler. Encore, encore. There's more, much more, lots more. More pure enchantment and more sheer delight. More joys to last through the day to the night.
Loads of enlightenment.
Lots you can learn.
And we are willing now to bet.
You just ain't seen nothing yet. Well, so as you wander through this wonderland, you'll find the wonders you never had planned. You think you had it, you don't understand. There's no need to toss out your arms. There's more.
More pure enchantment.
More, more.
Pleasant jokes to last through the nighttime.
More, more.
Lots to learn from things that enlighten.
More, more.
You will get your money's worth.
It's the biggest show on earth. You mustn't stop now, there's magic ahead. Don't cash your chips and keep winning instead.
Life is a kumquat.
What?
Like somebody said.
So don't be around.
Now we are back in Disney World, and to prove it, here's the Mickey Mouse Review.
Put them together and what have you got? Bippity-boppity-boo. Salagadoola means Menchikabooleroo. But the thingamabob that does the job is bippity-boppity-boo. Salagadoola, Menchikabooleroo, bippity-boppity-boo. Put them together and what have you got? Bippity-boppity, bippity-boppity, bippity-boppity-boo.
Mr. Bluebird on my shoulder.
Hello again, everybody. This is your track announcer, Chick Hearn. And ladies and gentlemen, the most spine-tingling event of this or any other sports season. You will see four of the world's top racing drivers using the most modern racing equipment, putting their skill and brains and raw courage on the line, battling one another in a scorching drive to the checkered flag. Introducing Mr. Mark Donahue, twice winner of the U.S. Road Racing Championship, three-time winner of the Trans-American Sedan Series. Mr. Bobby Unser, one of the famous Unser racing family, and recent winner of the Indianapolis 500. And Mr. Jackie Stewart, current world driving champion. And Mr. Leonard Hackett. Gentlemen, start your engines.
I'll get the blue job with the round wheels. All right, you guys. You asked for it. Funny, there's supposed to be a fork in the road.
Hi, y'all. I'm Carl Crackle from Weevil Seed, Georgia. I'm sort of a tracker, you might say. These are my two dogs here, Jesse and Kudja, just playing around there in the sand. They're good hound dogs, I tell you. You know, a little while back here, about 15 or 20 minutes ago, there was like a crazy man went through here. He must have had 6 to 8 kids, looked at least that many. He come up upon me and Kudja and Jesse, and he said, you a tracker? And I said, you lose them, we get them. That's a little tracker funny that I always throw in when we, well, shoot. At any rate, he said, I've lost the missus. I lost my wife. Could you help me out? He said, what about them two dogs? He said, the one dog. And I said, which one? Now, make sure you, and he pointed over to Jesse, and Jesse kind of looked up at him, rolled his eyes around and everything. He said, that dog's coat's kind of mangy, ain't it? And I said, it is kind of mangy. I said, that's his second coat. His first coat was a good one, but his second coat, that's borrowed from the VA. The other dog is just, well, he put his nose there in some kind of bobcat trap. And somebody asked me the other day, they said, how does he smell? And I said, terrible. That's a little swamp joke. Oh, shoot. I don't believe these two dogs could ever find that woman. I'm not kidding. Of course, Jesse here now, about 6 or 8 years ago, there was a hurricane down here, and he lost all his teeth. And prior to that, why, one day he was just sitting there. He only had about 6 or 8 good ones, good teeth, that is. And he commenced to kind of howl through his teeth, like, and he was howling the... The Battle Hymn of the Republic. He didn't go over too good down here. Folks thought he was a bluebelly. They booed him. He put his tail between his legs and he cut on out like that. I shouldn't be laughing like that, but I had a log fall on me here Sunday week and I haven't been right since. Well, at any rate, like I say, these two dogs, they used to track folks, you know, but here lately, they've gotten so old, and one of them's kind of tetched. He just runs around in circles. That's Cudgy. He just goes around like here. You know, that's not right for anybody to do it, let alone a dog. Well, y'all take care here. As far as catching that woman, these two dogs, they couldn't do it. I'll tell you why, because they got sinus conditions, both of them. I have two. So about three of us, I guess you might as well say we're out of it. Y'all take care here. If you see that guy, why, tell him I said hello. I sure do hope he catches the messes. It's kind of fun catching the messes, isn't it? Yeah, once in a while. Y'all take care. Come on, Cudgeon Jesse. Come on, boy. Come on, boys. What's that? Good night. Why, there's cowboys.
Look around at the sky and the ground, every leaf, every tree. Look around at the joys to be found, shining and new, waiting for you. Everywhere I look, I see a world. Everywhere I turn, I see a world full of love. Simple things become appealing. What a simply super feeling. Every time I take a look. Face full of love, hold a child in my arms, there's an arm full of love. When you're willing to care, you'll find joy everywhere in this wonderful world full of love. Take a friend by the hand, a hand full of love, hold a hope in your heart, there's a heart full of love. Every bird flying by,
You know, this fantastic scene is a tribute to the vision, imagination, and genius of Walt Disney. Walt Disney World is the culmination of a lifetime devoted to bringing joy and excitement and laughter to children and adults in America and throughout the world. You got to see this place. It's Dream City. New York, Paris, London, that's where the action is, but this is where the fun is. This is the place to relive your youth. You just walk in and you get 30 years off for good behavior. There's a spirit here, everywhere. It's in the air, everywhere you look. All this is Walt. This is what Walt wanted for all of us. An escape from our aspirin existence into a land of sparkle and lights and rainbows. Today, his name is more than just a household word for laughter, fun, and joy. It's a signal to the minds of the children of all ages. Cheer up. All is not lost. Entertainment is on the way. There's another message that Walt Disney communicated, and if you look around you here in this splendid monument to the man, you'll sense it as I did. Walt Disney loved America. He loved its traditions. He loved its children and their moms and pops. And he must have loved the parents to treat them to so many restful hours while their kids were camped at the local movie house. Walt Disney loved the American way of life. He loved it so much that he recreated many of this nation's most joyful periods. Frontierland, Main Street USA, way down yonder in New Orleans. Talking presidents that you can hear and enjoy here in Disney World today. Walt Disney loved America because his dream came true right here in America. He brought to us the delightful images of a kind of kaleidoscope of sound, motion, color, music, and beauty, and he tied it all up into one broad, beautiful, bountiful package called love. Maybe that's what we ought to rename this place, From Disney with Love. The entire world owes Walt Disney a great debt. He achieved much, but perhaps his greatest accomplishment is that he made children of us all.
United States Army Band now salute the grand entry of the Walt Disney World 1,076-piece ceremonial marching band under the direction of music man Meredith Wilson. Our thanks to Glen Campbell, star of The Glen Campbell Show.